KEB's C6 router can be used for remote monitoring and programming of PLCs and other automation devices through a secure VPN connection. The VPN connection is set up using KEB's CombiVis Connect software. This video will review how to configure and connect a C6 router to a KEB C6 Compact embedded controller using CombiVis Connect. Keep in mind that this is only an example of how to get started. The same basic steps reviewed in this video can be used for any PLC or VFD you are connecting to. To get started, power the router with a 24-volt DC power supply. Then connect a network cable with internet access connected to your PC's network to the WAN port on the router. Start up CombiVis Connect software and log in with a licensed domain username and password. We will use my own demo domain for this video. The domain space is used for device access, user creation, and security policies such as firewalls and access rights. Further information regarding CombiVis domain navigation and setup will be discussed in a different video. After logging in, navigate to the Router Configuration tab in CombiVis Connect. The router can be configured in two ways, either using a local network connection or from an exported configuration file using a USB stick. This video illustrates the configuration using a local network connection. Select the Local Area Network option. Then, enter the login credentials found on the router nameplate. Once entered correctly, CombiVis Connect software will display the MAC address of the connected router. Highlight the MAC address and select Configure. From here, you will see a variety of options for configuration. First, set up the WAN port to establish internet connection. The router can obtain an IP address statically or automatically from a DHCP server. My network will automatically provide client computers with an IP address, so I will check the Obtain IP config box. Keep in mind that your network settings will be different. Consult your IT team for the proper network settings. Next, to access your automation devices, configure the LAN interface or the serial port. For this example, I will enter the IP address and mask of my C6 Compact connected to the LAN port of the router. For devices that use a serial interface, the C6 router supports RS-232, RS-422, RS-485, and MPI hardware. Select the correct hardware with the drop-down options. After defining your device connections, various access modes can be defined in the General Options tab. We can set a new password for router configuration access. We can also specify the data access method. For safety, data is only transmitted based on user preference. For this demo, I will select the router to always transmit data. However, data transmission can be enabled using a hardware input or SMS message for router versions with an integrated modem. Lastly, leave connection port and proxy information at its default options. Upon configuration completion, the router must be registered in a folder in your CombiVis Connect domain. I will register this to my demo folder. Apply the configuration settings and the C6 router will reboot. Notice, the router will now appear online in the device tree. At this point, we are ready to establish a VPN connection to the router. Select Connect to establish a connection to the router. Once connected, I can now program or monitor my C6 Compact with the CombiVis Studio programming environment using the virtual Ethernet port set up by CombiVis Connect. If you are using a serial interface, CombiVis Connect will create a virtual COM port for device access. If you have any questions or need help connecting to the C6 router, please call KEB America to speak with a controls automation specialist.